First Wednesdays is sponsored by the Vermont Humanities Council and by the Kellogg Hubbard Library, with video production supported by Orca Media.
Program coming up is May 2nd, and that will be at Kellogg Hubbard Library, and I certainly hope you'll all be able to join us then. So, we are really excited to have the Thetford Chamber Singers with us tonight. It was organized in the fall of 1978 by founding director Valerie Miller, who led the ensemble until 2011. Now led by singer and composer Kevin Quigley, TCS is an auditioned chorus comprising nearly 50 men and women from a dozen Upper Valley towns. Diverse in age and livelihoods, these performers are drawn together through the joy of singing and a commitment to sharing adventurous, complex, and engaging music with the community. Okay, so now you know what you're in for tonight. You're excited. So the TCS repertoire is distinguished by the wide variety of musical styles representing varied traditions from ancient to very contemporary composers, beautifully woven together with poetry and other recitations. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about the Thetford Chamber Singers, there is more information in the program, including some of their upcoming concerts. And I did read my paper. So please join me in welcoming the Thetford Chamber Singers.
song full of manhood, womanhood, infancy, full of common employments, full of grain and trees. Oh, the joy of my spirit, it is uncaged, it darts like lightning. It is not enough to have this globe for a certain time. I will have thousands of globes and all time. Oneself I sing, a simple, separate person. I celebrate myself and sing myself, a song of the rolling earth and of words according. I sing the body, electric. I will sing the song of companionship. Come, said the muse, sing me a song no poet yet has chanted. Sing me the universal. Walt Whitman.
Thank you. Good evening. I am Kevin Quigley, the director of the Thetford Chamber Singers. We are so delighted to be up here. I want to say that our chorus is about 50 voices strong. And what the singing for you is what we call our outreach ensemble. And that's a few dedicated singers. Sometimes it's as many as half. Right now, I think it's about a third of us that want more opportunities to sing. So when the Vermont Humanities Council came along and let us know about this program, we immediately said yes, and we started to put it together. Every piece that we'll be singing today is in English, because we want the connection between the language of the poems and the music that each setting has put them to be as clear for an English-speaking audience as possible. If you're interested, we are singing our 40th anniversary spring concert in May. And the theme for that one, we do themed programming, is on connecting with the present moment. Our winter concert was on taking a look at the past, and then this particular 40th anniversary year, we've added another concert on June 30th, at the end of June, on taking a look towards the future. Our spring pieces, we're singing in five languages for there. We've got English, Latin, French, German, and Icelandic in that particular program. It's a fabulous program, extremely interesting music. All the way from Renaissance through something that was just written for this concert. We commissioned Vermont composer Kathy Wanson Eddy to write a piece for us, and it is phenomenal. So we're looking forward to that, and if you'd like to make a trip down to Thetford to hear us sing, we're singing in Stratford, Vermont on May 9th, in Woodstock, Vermont on the 11th, and then back home in Thetford for two shows on the Sunday the 13th. All right. One last little bit to make sure that the connection between the language and each arrangement of each piece is as clear as we possibly can. We're going to read each poem for you before we sing.
I go among trees and sit still. All my stirring becomes quiet around me, like circles on water. My tasks lie in their places where I left them, asleep like cattle. Then what is afraid of me comes and lives a while in my sight. What it fears in me leaves me, and the fear of me leaves it. It sings, and I hear its song. Then what I am afraid of comes. I live for a while in its sight. What I fear in it leaves it, and the fear of it leaves me. It sings, and I hear its song. After days of labor, mute in my consternations, I hear my song at last, and I sing it. As we sing, the day turns, the trees move. Wendell Berry.
Thank you.
Raced sideways while blowing bubbles. And May came home with a smooth, round stone, as small as a world and as large as a bubble. For whatever we lose, like a you or a me, it's always ourselves we find in the sea. E.E. Cummings.
Dominic has a doll. wired to the radiator of a zoom doom ice cold wood truck. A wistful little clown whom somebody buried upside down in an ash barrel, so of course Dominic took him home. And Mrs. Dominic mended his bright torn trousers, quite as if he were really her and she, but and so that's how Dominic has a doll. Dominic has a doll, and every now and then my wonderful friend Dominic De Paola gives me a most tremendous hug, knowing, I feel, that we and worlds are less alive than dolls and dream. E.E. Cummings.
Cants were born to happen. Our mosts have died in more. Our 20th will open wide, a wide open door. We are so both and oneful. Night cannot be so sky. Sky cannot be so sunful. I am through you, so I. E.E. Cummings.
Oh, sets the loom to frame, a blanket designed without a name, of colors too rife to call by tone or hue, showing the world in shades of brown and blue. The skeins of yarn lie in the room, on chairs and floor around the loom. The weaver loves their colors and their touch, and marvels they in silence say so much. The cloth that shelters old and young is all from this same magic spun. Their strength is in their closeness drawn. By loom and hand, each yarn is strong. Draw the strands together tight, bold colors glowing in the light. The threads that make the fabric warm will keep this family safe from harm. Brian Welch.
Thank you. day the universe was born, mountains rose and stars were torn from the woven cloth of time, and there were no fences. Boundaries were not in the plan for sky and ocean, earth and man. Freedom's only ours to share where there are no fences. In photographs from far in space, earth and oceans have their place, a graceful blanket, blue and green, and there are no fences. But man forgot somewhere in time the earth's not yours or theirs or mine, and for children yet to be, there must be no fences. Borders, boundaries, walls, and wire burn a soul with freedom's fire. Hope is born when we decide there will be no fences. Today's the day we can decide to mend the fabric we divide, a seamless cloth of you and me without any fences.
Sings the tune without the words and never stops at all. And sweetest in the gale is heard, and sore must be the storm that could abash the little bird that kept so many warm. I've heard it in the chillest land and on the strangest sea, yet never in extremity, it asked a crumb of me. Emily Dickinson.
Sings the tune and sings the tune,
all without the world,
and never. marches in the soul and sings the tune and never stops. And sweetest in the air is heard, and so must be the storm
that could abash the little bird that kept so many more. I've heard it in the chillest land and on the strangest sea, yet never in extremity.
So we had a bit of a dilemma. We put it together a program specifically for the winter. We figure we're performing in February on the second Wednesday, dragging people out of their warm houses. So we've got a number of songs about snow in this show. And we thought, oh, we just got snowed out with our snow program. It was delayed till April. Do we make a change? Right? Somebody had the brilliant idea, well, we got snowed out. We should honor the snow, right? It's still here? I did the math. It's the 108th day of January. So the next two are pieces of mine. I've written lots of songs about snow. I love snow, even when it's here in April. These are hot off the presses. You are the second audience to hear them.
Cheers in snow.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Quiet upon the terraces, the garden chairs repose. In fall, they wore their sooty dress. Now the lees of snows. How like the furnishings of youth in backyards of the mine. Residuals of summer's truth in seasons left behind.
Oh,
vines, leaves, roots of darkness growing. Now you are uncurled and cover our eyes with the edge of winter sky, leaning over us in icy stars. Come with your seasons, your fullness, your end. Annie Finch.
Vines, leaves, roots of darkness growing. Vines, leaves, roots of darkness growing.
Longfellow. mountains and the wood. I turned and looked the other way and saw three islands in a bay. So with my eyes I traced the line of the horizon, thin and fine, straight around till I was come back to where I'd started from. And all I saw from where I stood was three long mountains and a wood. Over these things I could not see. These were the things that bounded me, and I could touch them with my hand, almost, I thought, from where I stand. And all at once things seemed so small, my breath came short and scarce at all. But sure the sky is big, I said, miles and miles above my head. So here upon my back I'll lie and look my fill into the sky. Edna St. Vincent Millay.
From where I stood.
our final two pieces are real Vermont pieces. We've got Nathaniel Blue's rendition of our state song. You don't know our state song, I have to say, having sung all over the place, having sung many state songs, it's a rare beauty. It's really a beautiful piece. Nat Lou teaches at St. Mike's College in Colchester and is the director of Counterpoint. If you've seen us sing, Counterpoint has sung in this room quite often. And then we'll end with a once Vermont resident. Gwyneth Walker lived in Randolph for many, many decades. Now lives in Connecticut, I believe. But she's got this beautiful setting of texts that are about living and being in New England. So we'll read that one before we sing it. But the state song, you just get to listen. There we go. I'm reading this one. The shore suggests the seashore, and what I see in the distance looks like seals on a sandbar. Dear to me to lie in the sand, fit to preserve the bones of a race for 1,000 years to come. This is my home, my native soil, and I am a New Englander. Of thee, O earth, are my bones and sinew made. To thee, O earth, am I brother. This is my home, my native soil, and I am a New Englander. Henry David Thoreau.
Page 11. Not slow.
The shore suggests the sea. Oh.
concerts in the Upper Valley, Stratford, Woodstock, and Thetford, May 9th, 11th, and 13th. A completely different program than what you saw tonight, but it's really good. So if you'd like to make the journey, it'll be worth it. Thank you so much.
To the Lord, our sons and daughters.